Ready, boys?
Let's do this.
Bringing Detune to the future, boys. +3 to firebolt, please. Diablo in VR, boys. In the cave. We're gonna one more time. One more time. You ever played D2 in VR before? It's Blizzard's latest thing. Your leader. Keep running. New speedrun category. Daft Punk percent. That's right. Ouch. Gloves, no thanks. No thanks. These early levels are so helpful. Did I forget it, dude? God, I hope not. I hope not. You removed 3 masks. Tenfast cast rate? Unfortunately, it can't be. Can't find one in the den. Can't find one in the den. Doesn't look like we missed anybody. Oh, it was a rare Kappa. I'll do all those numbers. Fill up. I don't want to have to move it. Cool. I could have looked for a faster cast rate wand, actually. I had enough gold for it. Gold is pretty absurd to start with. It is pretty absolutely ridiculous to start the game with. Quilted armor though. Yeah, buddy, got my two open socket. Make a stealth with that later. Alright, was there a break off anywhere that you guys saw before? Yes, there's that one. This looks like it could be potential stony. Yeah, okay, sweet. Nice. Boss group to start us off. I like it. What's our next split? Start tower. Okay. I added some new splits there. Just to add more splits to it, because everybody used to always say, like, I mean, because normally the Act 1 split is like 35 minutes or whatever. So it's like, alright. This run's long enough. Let's add some more splits. So. Never. Excuse me. Never. Future gunners. Yeah, this is what the gunners of the future look like right here. This is what they look like. I don't want to fight champions. Ooh. Get me out of there. Those guys are just not worth it. They're worth so little experience compared to what you're going to get from them. I missed a small charm on the stones. Eh. I got enough gold. I need to make sure I don't get too far this way. Alright, I don't like arm running now. I want to go back. I want to go that way. So, in this map, it's not... You can't always tell where the heck you need to go. But you want to kind of stick left center more. Left straight. Okay, that doesn't lead us anywhere either. But there's a lot of stuff to kill, at least. And get a level up out of it. Guess not. There it is. And get a little health. That would be really good. Right straight. Yeah, I meant I was saying left straight just for this map. For the viewers to make it a little easier. So Diablo 2 is kinda randomized maps. It's like pseudo random, whatever. So yeah, it's left of the way it came in, but since I came in facing on that like angle, right would actually be down bottom in that case. I know that probably doesn't make much sense, so just ignore that. Alright. Start tower is the next one. Maybe I should do a split on the... It actually wouldn't be too bad to do a split on Darkwood or Underground Passage. Because that's a good like place to check. You want to get out a little bit earlier on there if you can. Alright. Let's find out what kind of Black Marsh we have here. Hopefully it's not... What up, Excalibur? Hopefully it's not a crappy one. So we have a potential to be rivered right now. We still have potential to be rivered right now. Yeah. Which is not good. Getting rivered is where you have a river running straight through your map. There it is. Yep, I thought we might. Alright, so now we have to hope that our waypoint and our tower are on the same side of the river. Because if they're on separate sides, river VM. It's just one of those, like when you walk into it, you just get that feeling in your gut and you're like, oh god, it's a river. Not every direction can have a river. Your map has to face to the bottom left, right, or top left. Yeah, rip river runs. Alright, we lose two of our... it's not even worth checking over there, if the waypoint's there, because if it is, then we'll just have to repeat. Why do I tab a lot? I tab a lot, and I press Q a lot. Just like... there's no good reason for it. We got one shrine, that's nice. I don't know why I grabbed it. Stamina, I already had stamina. It's just, like, hotkey... or, like, APM spam, right? Like when StarCraft players are constantly, like, boxing and pressing stuff, you just, like, want to keep your fingers warm and everything. And so that's one way that I've always done that. So that was a cursed boss right there, so I definitely did not want him. Alright, not too bad of a map. Maybe if we get a second shrine. Nah, no second shrine. Alright. That map isn't terrible. So we're starting 1033. Level 5 is honestly the bigger concern there. I don't really want to be level 5 at 1033. That's not ideal. That's not my, like, favorite place to be. So in these maps, I always want to run left of the way I come in. So I've come in facing top left, so I want to go to the bottom left. And I also want to find bosses, of course. Because this is where I get a huge piece. A lot of people think, like, oh, you just go get your runes in here and that's it. Even if there weren't runes, like if I run a normal run of this game, I'm still going to be, like, running down here. Just because it's such good experience. It's like some of the best experience you can get. Because you just get so many boss groups. And boss groups are where all your experience really comes from. Oh, that was a boss group. Okay. He's lightning enchanted though. I don't really want to fight him. Oh, don't kill me. Okay. We'll kill a couple guys. Move on. So yeah, you can see like every time it's just like natural. So I came in bottom to the bottom right. So now I want to just go up to this top. And we actually, it looks like we got a second boss group down here. So if you have this weird, kind of turn right here. See how this is like an L shape in the map without a door? Doot doot, like that. There's always a boss there, and it gives you a chance to have a second boss, basically, down here, which is really nice, because double boss groups are worth a ton. Okay, let's get throwing knives, get some of that. We don't need that leather armor. Alright, looks like we didn't get one. Looks like we didn't get that. No second boss. No second boss. I wonder if I should split each run. That could honestly not be a bad idea. There's always some sort of balance that you have to figure out here. There's always some sort of balance that you have to figure out between, like, wow, what terrible drops. Lith, oh my gosh. Alright, doesn't get too much worse than that. You already got that, okay. That is that's a pretty painful drop setup right there. So I can get rid of the L's, I want that actually. Let's look for faster cast rate, nice. Okay, so faster cast rate's really, really helpful in this game. Did I have a shrine out here? I didn't, I thought it was, it's not. We got one shrine, experience, nope. That stinks. So having experience shrines is really helpful. What is on your face? This is my Daft Punk stream. Daft Punk percent world record. I don't know. Let's go around. Try Diablo 2 with Ryu in a multiplayer game. I tried that with Teo one time. It was kind of boring. One person has to run a sorceress, right? Because sorceress is the fastest character. So one person runs a sorceress, the other character runs whatever, and then you just, like, go really quickly through the game, and that's it. And then it's over. Or you don't even go, like, that quick, because it's just, like, get the sorceress to 18, and then it just becomes a sorceress speedrun with a little bit more killing power. So it's really not as fun as it sounds. Additionally, you have all the lag, you have like joining game issues, you have Battle.net disconnecting you. Just crap like that. I mean, it just doesn't work out like you would honestly hope it would. And you say, oh, you could play TCP/IP then. But like trying to join a game in TCP/IP takes like 5 minutes. So. Mm-hmm. I'm not practicing commentating a GDQ game. It's just with some people from the front page here and stuff. They don't know Diablo 2. So I'm trying to give a better Diablo 2 sense, you know. How is Diablo 2 speedrunning run? What is it? What does it look like? Yada, yada, yada. So I'm trying to explain my actions a little bit better, just so you guys can understand. So if you have any questions, I mean, feel free to ask. I'm always open. So once again, here's that same boss group, and I'm going to see that same boss group every single time that I'm down here, except there's like a, I mean, it's like 98% of the time that you see it. There's like 2% chance that it doesn't show up or something like that. I don't know what the exact number is on it and everything, but it's somewhere around there. When you have that, you're pretty happy. Because, like, down here and stuff, this boss group, next time I'm down here, may not be down here. Who knows? So, I'm entering from that side over there. So, it looks like if I go straight down to the bottom, the Countess has 2 spawn points, and it's not decided until you're literally in act, or in Tower Cellar level 5. There we go. There's one of the runes we need. That's good. So it's not decided until, like, you enter it right there. Let's go ahead and get some strength on so we can start going and buying some items here. No, I do need a shield, though. Get rid of that and grab a sash. Okay. Cool. That'll work. And I should probably get my next point in telekinesis. That'll help me be a little faster. That'll help me be a little faster. When's the next GDQ event? When is AG? It'll be SGDQ, so it'll be sometime in summer. June, I want to say. I want to say it's June. Something like that. All right, so now I'm going to grab one in telekinesis. And that'll just be useful for, like, grabbing waypoints, grabbing shrines, which I don't think I checked the shrine this time. That was a poor choice by me. The goal is 80% normal sorceress. 80% normal sorceress. So I want to get through normal. As fast as possible. So this tower isn't great. Yeah, I missed the shrine, I know. That was my bad. This tower isn't great. Oh god. Extra fast. In that there's really not a ton of experience here, even though I have double setup with those L shapes, which you really don't see too often. the boss groups are pretty crappy. So each of those boss groups give like different things. The reason I pop all of those little things is because there's a good chance of dropping amulets, rings, things like that, jewelry. And jewelry is very helpful for me because I need faster cast rate. So I need faster cast rate, either ring or amulet. I just need one for this run. For a hell run, I'll need a second one. But for this run, darn, I just need one of them. So you just kind of are... You want to find that as fast as you can. Like, I got it on my wand, but I still need one other piece somewhere else. And the reason for that is once I get stealth, stealth gives me 25 faster cast rate. This will push me to 35, but the next breakpoint for faster cast rate is 37 for a sorceress. So what that means essentially is, for sure, don't worry, for sure. What that means is this game is built... it's 25 FPS, and that's built into the game, so, like, even if you have a massive computer that can, you know, run any game whatsoever, it's not going to help it much. But additionally, it means that, like, there's certain... Darn, these drops are just not good. There's, like, breakpoints that'll push you up to the next frame. So if I'm casting on, you know, 8 frames per second, to get to 7 frames per second, I have to reach a certain point. And so for cast rate, for a sorceress, 37 is one of those breakpoints. And that's like an ideal one here. So that's one that I kind of like aim for. And so a lot of things that, you know, sometimes a lot of people don't understand or whatever, is if I am running and there's still a couple minions on there I want to kill or something. I guess not. If I have, like, 37 faster cast rate, or if I have 40 8 faster cast rate or 52 faster cast rate. That is all within the exact same breakpoint. So I will not teleport any bit faster until I hit the next breakpoint, which is 63. So it's a little confusing. What runes do I need for stealth? Tal-Eth. So the ideal rune drops down here are Tal-Eth, Tyr-Tyr, Rau-Rau. And the reason for that is tier runes give me mana per kill, which is super, super, super helpful later on. Mana per kill is like absolutely insanely necessary for this game. Just because, or it's not necessary, but it is pretty necessary if you want a world record. Just because Nova is super, super mana intensive. And so if you're like constantly out of mana and stuff, you just have to wait for your potions to generate more mana, and then they slowly, you know, they give you more mana, whatever not, and then you cast another Nova, and then you sit and wait, whatever. But if you have like a big group, dude, everything is lightning enchanted right now. It's driving me insane. If you have a big group of, gosh darn, that really, really blows. I don't like lightning enchants, especially down here. Sorry, one sec. Might as well kill him, I guess. Might as well kill him at that point. Alright, what was I saying? What was I even saying? Man. So the Countess can drop anywhere. I guess she can technically drop up to 6 runes. That would be like the craziest rare drop in the world. But a lot of times you'll see her drop like 3 runes, 4 runes, something like that. Oops, I want that shield. I'm gonna go buy it back. I forgot that that was the one I wanted. Alright, so I've got Tau Rau right now. If I find one more Eld rune, that'll be helpful, I guess. There we go, there's an experience shrine. We needed that. We need some experience. We need some experience. We probably needed a little more experience earlier. Alright, there's a ring. That's nice. Blind playthrough for the win. We'll do that. Our next 5 we can put into strength. I want to have 25 strength for a belt. So now I just have to watch out for cursed monsters. So you'll see me a lot of times hover over the boss group before I kill it. Or hover over the boss because you can see exactly what it is right under its name. So it'll say like cursed, extra fast, whatever it is. So I'm always, always, always giving a quick check. Especially if it's something, you know, so like that's aura enchanted, right? Which you could tell because it has an aura below it, but that's just habit. But yeah, I am always, always, always checking that stuff and looking for like cursed on archers because that is just a horrible way to lose an experience shrine. So, could you get 105 faster cast rate if you had Lidless? I mean, I wouldn't be able to use Lidless in a normal run. You can get to 105, but it's... 105 is pretty tough. What is back here? Is there a boss group here? There it is. Cool. So that's stone skin. Don't need to worry about that. Okay. Hopefully 2 open sockets. Nice. Alright. So we should be pretty good on our 2 open sockets here. I'm just really happy. Happy about that. That's a good piece. So I want that because that's where I'm going to be socketing my runes, right? So like those Rau runes I was talking about. Those could go in there, or tier runes. Honestly, it depends what you pick. So you can either have... there we go, we'll do this. I actually don't want to use the shield right now. Because I don't want to be blocking right now. Because blocking takes frames. Using the Vive or the Oculus Rift. It's my own special brand. Do I respec at 13 on this run? Yeah. Well, actually, no. No, I don't. I used to. Not anymore. Alright, so we got Tal-Eth. Tal-Eth Rau. So, that's not bad there. Alright, let's get rid of that. Ith, don't need that. I guess we need the rest of those. That'll work. All my gold is gone. Skill shrines are also decent. They help you speed up your run a little bit there. Just kind of bolstering. That charge bolt. Oh, okay. There's a boss group. So I was really hoping that we could have had more like one boss group on our way every time or something. That would have been really helpful. But they kind of spawn randomly. So gotta hope for them. Kerr explained light, cold, enchanted monsters, along with resistances and immunities. What do you want to know about them? I actually want to get that head. I don't want all that. So basically, I mean, with resistances, you have like, you know, if something is light immune or whatever, it basically just means the resistance of that monster is over 100, or in hell or whatever, you know, over 200 at that point, because everything gets a negative 100. So if a monster has over 100 resistance, then it becomes immune, and you have to have something to break that immunity, such as Infinity with Conviction Aura, or Conviction Aura straight from Paladin, or low resist from a wand or from the Necromancer, whatever it is. So you have to be able to break it somehow. That's nothing down there. So really just depends. I actually haven't seen a lot of champion groups down here, which is nice, but there still hasn't been enough experience from the other stuff. Try and grab those mana potions. What up, developer? Ah, darn. Where's that boss group? Hopefully up here. Hopefully boss group right up here. Doesn't look like it. Just not enough experience on this run, honestly. Unfortunately. Like I said, each one of those, I mean, there just wasn't... We were running into little, like, fallens and stuff, and they just don't give much at all. So, who knows? One more experience run? Nope. Diablo in VR, boys. Diablo in VR. For saying to ski. So I went skiing a week ago. And it was my first time skiing, and it was amazing. I thought this was a speedrun, all you're doing is running the same thing. So this is a piece of the speedrun. It's... I don't want to say unfortunate, but, like, this is Diablo 2. I mean, you know that Diablo 2's got a little farm in it, right? That's just kind of standard D2. So, in this case, this is the grindiest part of the run. Once I get to... This run finishes. This is my last run of it. Once this run finishes, that'll be it, and I'm gonna be moving on. Diablo 2 in VR. So yeah, this is the one piece of it that you're like, all right, you know, like, come on, I wanna get past it. And often you're running that multiple times, right? Because you're trying to like get that regular, whatever it is. So you're all over the place. So I probably didn't want to pick those up. That'll work. Actually want to get some. Let's get some mana in there. Yeah, not enough. Why is the map revealed? Because I've already been through this part of the map. So in single player, when you find a map, yeah, I have Talith Rao, so I'm short one Rao rune, and then I'm short. Feltalunata. We'll use that. Increase block rate. Give me the plus energy. I really like that. Plus energy is probably the best part of that. That's really nice. So, uniques don't make like a huge effect in this game unless they're crazy, whatever, but that's still nice. Still nice to find. Engage Teo Axe. That's right. You're looking for that soul rune? Well, you just gotta keep going. So, yeah, it can be a grind on the Countess for sure. I'd love some tier runes right now. Eldral. Alright, that actually is perfectly fine. That actually works out okay. Because now I have 3 Eldrunes, so. That'll do it. And, alright, we got our faster cast rate ring. Nice. can sell that later if we need, whatever. Alright, so we have Tal, don't need that. We got our second Ral, you go over here, don't need you. Tal Eth, okay, cool. So that'll all morph into one tier, and I wish I could have it a little earlier, but I'm gonna have to wait until later on for that. So I'm gonna drink these. Stamina potions do stack in this game. It's a fun fact that not everybody knows. And the nice thing is we at least are on this side of the river as well. So that puts us over here to exit this a little bit faster. I was eating those staminas, or drinking them. I guess you don't really eat stamina potions, but I was drinking them. So I get 30 seconds per stamina potion I drank. So I just drank like, probably like 12 minutes worth or something. So I want to kill all these boss groups. That is a huge thing, and all of their minions as well. Thawings also stack, antidote stack. It only stacks duration though, so make sure you note that. But yeah, so these guys right here, these champions that I'm killing, these give 300% experience, and those boss groups that I just killed give 500% experience. So that is very good to note, right? For future, because you want to have as much experience and as little killing time as possible. So if I see like big groups of things, sometimes I'll kill. I've got pink eye. That's right. That's why I'm wearing this. If I've got like, you know, whatever, then I don't mind killing if there's a giant pack of something. But if it's just me. And like one monster and he's not a boss or something, not worth it at all. Not worth it at all. And that's one of the difficult things of Diablo 2 speedrunning, is that you have to always be like considering what's the benefit of like killing something versus moving on, everything like that. Are we in emote only mode? Is that what happened? Looks like it. Let go. Alright, so we have end tower. So enter catacombs is my next split. Alright. And like I said before, I just added some splits. So I'm really gonna try and like, what is up? Welcome back, 3. Appreciate that, bud. See that. Or I should not I shouldn't say welcome back, I should say welcome. Welcome to the Llamas of the Round. Appreciate the support, bud. Appreciate the support. Let's get those llamas in that chat. So right now I just want to find the exit. If I find the butcher, which looks like we have, that's all right. I will go ahead and take this, and hopefully that malice turns into something really nice. So it looks like our exit's right there. That's a little bit of a long barracks. Sometimes you just get in and you immediately turn and you're good to go. But you never really know. So once again, maps are procedurally generated, so you have no clue which way to go, with the exception of I know like I need to go somehow across this map. So I know it's not like behind me facing the other direction. I know I need to move across. It looks like we actually found it. That's really nice. Hope I got that guy. And then I need to go across on this map as well. So I'm always gonna be looking. So since I started entering, like my entrance is facing top left, the entrance block, I want to move towards the top left. So you're always gonna see me trying to like hover around this top left, if possible. And then I'll just wait for it to cut up, which I'm guessing is right here. There we go. And kill some champions, and that should be just above us here. So another really important thing with Diablo 2 is recognizing the like hit rate and stuff, right? So it doesn't look, Diablo 2 looks easier to play than it is, or like run stuff, because a lot of it You don't get to feel like when you get hit and what the hit recovery is like on that. So that's a big, big, big piece. And now I want to go left on this. But that's a big, big piece that I'm always trying to be, like, be aware of, is watching for bolts, knowing which things will like stun me more than others and things of that nature. So you always want to be looking out for that stuff. So we're going to be heading over to the left here. And this is one of those. It could be down there. It could be up here. I just know I want to go this way to the top right somehow. So I don't want to go up that way. That's a dead end. So we can try over here now. And I'm just going to hope this leads me. And it does. Cool. All right. So that takes us to your cloister. Which is nice. Which is always nice. I'm going to go ahead and grab one in static. Just because static is probably the one most OP spells in the game. Those are demons. I thought that was a boss group. I was really hoping so. Okay, so I'm looking now. Now we're in the catacombs. Level 1 and level 3, I have absolutely zero idea where to go. I straight up just have to guess. This is the most unfortunate piece of certain parts of this run, is you just get no information. So there's like little map cues, like I knew that that would lead to a dead end right there. So I knew that I didn't want to go in there. But other than like little map cues, it basically just puzzle pieces things together and builds a map. And I just kind of have to be at the mercy of the map. This is probably one of my least favorite boss groups. But I draw it a lot, unfortunately. And all those things are really not fun for stuns. It's debatable if I should even really try and fight them. So, I just gotta dodge the balls. You can dodge a spoon, you can dodge a ball, right? So that wasn't bad kill time on it. And I want a little more experience. I'm only level 13 and a third. I usually want to be a little closer to 14 here. So if I can get some boss groups down here, that'll be nice. Like that. Alright. Maybe down there. Nope. Doesn't look like it. Oh. Cool. There it was. Just to our right. Did I not split that? Alright. Sorry. My inner catacomb split was late. My bad. I forgot to split it. These are new splits. I just put these splits in here to try and have better, like, view for you guys and also for myself, so I can be more aware of like where I am and where I can speed up and slow down and whatever not, because that's always super helpful. Okay, hopefully this leads us somewhere. Come on now. So yeah, so level 2, there is a little, I don't want to say cheat, but hint as to where you want to go. And it's to the right of the waypoint, so I actually didn't find the waypoint, but if I found the waypoint, then that would give me a sense of where I need to move towards. So that's always really helpful. That'll lead me nowhere. As you can see, my stamina is still blue. That, of course, is thanks to chugging all those stamina potions. So it's just something that it makes it so I don't have to worry about it. I don't really want to deal with another boss group of them. Unfortunately. Unfortunately, we drew that boss group another time. So Tainted have high light res. So that's why I don't like dealing with them. Just takes a little bit more to kill as a lightning sorceress. Brutal. Alright. Take me to your leader? Maybe? Alright, here we go. Level 4. Okay. Why do I keep closing and reopening map and stuff? So, I reopen whenever the quest log is up. I always open the quest log. The reason is because it's super, super, super annoying. I just absolutely hate the quest log so much. And it just does, like, terrible things. Because you'll accidentally click it. I want to go ahead and close that door just so things aren't straggling through and stuff. That's one thing you can do in Diablo 2, is you can close doors behind you. which is always nice. And I'll go ahead and kill these guys as well. And let's get in Dariel down here. What up, Palesto? Thank you so much for the sub. Welcome to Llamas of the Round. I do appreciate it, bud. Yeah, alright. So we're going to try and get some statics off here real quick. In between, like, her faster hit recovery that she's putting us in. Alright. That's probably good enough. What up, P3? Thank you for the cheer, bud. Need to be careful not to die here. Let's see if that'll work at all. There we go. Okay. I want that, though. That'll be good money, and I need a little money. Okay. So now to take Warv over. Actually, before I do that, I'm going to go respec. So now I'm going to switch into a Nova build. We'll finish it up when we get over there. Okay, put one there. One there, one there. X, G, D, Z. Okay, cool. And let's get ourselves 29 strength. A little more energy. Okay. So I want a little more energy so I can have a little bit more mana. You generally aren't going to ever see anybody do anything for mana. But in speedruns, that's something that you will see. I didn't malice. Ooh, all res. That's really nice. And that'll be really good for our shield that we have over there. Perfect. And nothing I really want. Okay. So we'll clear that out. I'm going to go ahead and fill up on potions. The nice trick is with this belt, you have enough slots that you can really fill up pretty quickly. I'm still going to chug some staminas just to have a little bit more. And I should mail some boots, actually. That's a good idea. Let's get some white boots. There are no boots. That's why I didn't grab them. All right. So sometimes she sells boots. Sometimes she fills up and she doesn't sell boots, which she can't do. So no chance for a fast run knock on that. But that's something that I would do. So as you can see, now we are in the I need mana phase of this game. It's a really fun phase. So now I'm looking for an exit. One of the exits is going to be one of the corners. So it's either going to be in the corner right there that I just passed, which it was not. Oh, mana burn. That's annoying. It's going to be in another, one of the top corners. But it's important to really think about the maps kind of as squares here. If you really want a sense of, like, which way do I need to go, which whatever. So if I have a mana shrine nearby, I like to just, like, burn out mana really quick. But, yeah, so that way, like, I'm not going to ever check right there because I know that that's not a corner. Right, so always, always, always go to your corners, look for exits. There we go, we found a corner and an exit. Warmth is pointless. A lot of people always say, hey, put a point in warmth. Yeah, when you have, like, plus to 30 skills or whatever, it's not bad. But right here, like, absolutely pointless. Does nothing for me. All right, sweet. Found our halls really early. That's good. Now I need a waypoint. So I'm doing what's called, like, run ahead, you know, and then tilly back strats, essentially. So I'm going to run forward, try and find a waypoint, teleport back, go through my portal, complete the quest, and then I can immediately go back to my waypoint instead of having to constantly just sit and wait, or, like, go down there, and then I have no waypoint, and then I'm, like, running back out and, you know, doing all that stuff again. So I like these boss groups that we've got right here so far. That's been really nice. There's big enough clumps there that I don't really mind. I don't have anything. And once again, check corners. Always check your corners. Downloading the game right now. Hype. That's a dead end corner. So this map is kind of rectangular in this shape. So I want to go up here now. Check, like, up in this corner right here. And actually, you cannot judge if I look over there, I think that might be it. I think that might be the exit. Nitrix for 2 months in a row. Welcome back to Llamas of the Round. I think that might actually be our exit. Just by looking at that map, I think our exit's tucked away in there and I didn't quite go deep enough. Yep, there it is. There it is. GG, bud. Appreciate that. You cannot judge me. So we do have some beetles here, so I'm actually gonna load up on this. I'm gonna save that Pelts of Lunata for later, but right now this gives me 47 lightning resist, which is just like super, super, super helpful. Because if I don't have that lightning res, a lot of times that's a very easy, quick way to die. Beetles, lightning bolts, do a ton of damage. They also give you a ton of experience though. So it's kind of like a love-hate relationship, because I want beetles, but I also absolutely need to have some lightning resist, or I'm just gonna get destroyed by him. Or I have to be very, very, very careful. You cannot judge Moo. I am Moo Moo itself. What's world record hunting? World record hunting. Hunting that record. Yeah, so what I'm looking for now, once again, is that waypoint. I really want to find the waypoint before I find the maggot lair. That's pretty important to me. If I find the maggot lair first, I'm going to keep looking around for the waypoint. And I just have to kind of pray that they're nearby. And thankfully, we found the waypoint. So we can go back. Let's get some potions again. That I cannot answer for you, unfortunately. Okay, so we're going to now do the Halls of the Dead. Go get our cube. Get our cube split. So in the Halls of the Dead, you want to run left of the way you come in. The entrance is that way. So this is our quote-unquote left. Which I know I'm running to the right of your screen, but this is left of my entrance. So why not repair gloves? Because they're garbage. Don't even care about them. not worth the time. The only thing that I could care about is getting some boots and imbuing them and praying that they happen to be fast run walk, which now I'm level 14. Chances of it are going down. It's not great chances. All right. Dead end up there. How's it going? It's going good. How about you? Rip gloves. F in chat for gloves. F in chat for gloves. So yeah, I want to once again run left of the way I came in, which is this way. And there's our level 3. Res boots would be great as well. I do like res boots. I do like res boots. I have gloves. Yeah. I mean, you can always get some stuff. Faster hit recovery boots can be really good as well. I actually think faster hit recovery is a little bit underrated almost in speedrunning. So when somebody finds something like Blood Fist or whatever, it just like completely changes a run, because Blood Fists just have huge faster hit recovery, and it just gives you like such an advantage, I feel like. So that's one of the things that's mildly explored. Don't really need rings, but they're still worth good gold. Get our cube and a smoke sphere as well. Actually, we'll take that. So I'm going to do this. This will actually be a faster way to, if I talk to the right guy, to get out to that waypoint than if I were to make a town portal and head home. So now I'm going to find the maggot lair. I'll go ahead and do the maggot lair. Why not? I could run forward into the lost city there, but since the waypoint's there, it doesn't really matter. So I'll just continue on. Maybe I'll find more beetles down here. Hopefully I didn't get rid of my beetles. That could have been one reason to keep that map, is because I did have beetles. Would have given me more beetle exploration. More experience for that, but oh well. Ouch. Light belt. Oh, you know what? I've got the... No, I don't have magic find. I don't know why. I don't know why I'm dropping so many items like that. Okay, looking for the maggot lair. Yeah, VR goggles. Got like a HUD on my screen here. Helps me with my speedrunning. Yeah, so like Night Court is just going to be an instant sell, pretty much. And where's that maggot? Unfortunately, I did lose my belt. Or my beetles, not belt. They got a lot of the same letters, right? But... we still, you'll always have Beetle Burst boss group, so that's always nice. And it's always been like highly debated if you should farm this. I'll grab that chainmail just for gold, because gold is super important in this game. Super, super important. So it's always kind of debated if you want to... there we go, there's Mega Lair. If you want to... Oh god, what was I going to say? Chainmail got me all distracted. I want to run right, by the way, in this map. Chainmail got me all distracted. I saw gold in my eyes. Oh yeah, if you want to farm Beetle Burst, that's right. So sometimes, like, if you draw a waypoint and it's right there next to him, you'll be like, kind of want to go, like, farm this and just, like, save quit a couple times, come back in. So I know that was the wrong way, but once I saw that boss group there, it was like, gotta go, gotta go. Beetle group boss groups are the greatest thing since, I don't know, since Diablo 2 came out. How's that? Is that pretty good? We'll go with that. We'll go with that. More beetles. Always nice. So level 2. Once again, same idea. Want to continue right the way it came in. I don't like these boss groups quite as much. And also, some of you guys might have seen me put 7 into static field. And you're like, why would you put static? You only need 1. That is correct. It does not increase the damage at all. But... oh, this is really gross. It's not fun down here. Not fun down here at all. I'm gonna have to go get more potions. It's annoying. Oh yeah, I need to make my tier rune. That's right. That's fine. We'll go get more potions, make our tier rune, and then continue on. Let's see. Do I want in my helm or my shield? Probably in my helmet. Oh no, actually... ooh. That's kind of a problem now. I want to go look for... I guess I'll look for another helmet? I guess that's what we're going to have to do. This is not the best map. So we'll go identify our stuff. Build record is not 4612. That is the segmented. So that is where... oops, I don't need to do any of that stuff. You in there, you can go there, you can go there. Okay, can we get some boots? Cool. And nice. Alright, might as well pick up some light reds while we can. Let's take this guy out. I'll have to think on that tier in. Maybe I'll go look for another when I go empty these boots. It's actually not a bad idea. Let's go do that. Let's look for another shield. One open socket, 2 open sockets. We'll do that. So now we'll put our Rao runes in there. We can put a tier rune in this shield. Okay. We'll do that. That's right, no chance. Yeah, Teo doesn't hold the record for this. This is a pretty, pretty ugly map, so the exit should be right here, but just the distance to get all the way down here is kind of disgusting. Almost level 16, though. I am happy about that. That is good experience-wise, but... still, map-wise, not the happiest. So at level 17, we'll go ahead and activate our stealth. I'll probably activate a little bit before that. Just because why not? Just because why not? There's actually a bug in the game where when you activate it, it'll activate a little prematurely. Just temporarily. And then it'll like recognize it that it activated and turn off later. But you can get a little bit of benefit out of it. So that's nice. Okay. How long is this run? I'm guessing this one will end at like an hour 35? I mean, there's still a lot left to happen. We'll see what happens in our act 5 or our act 3. Act 4 and 5 really aren't going to have too much difference in them. I mean, you have a small difference in your timing, but it's not too bad. But your Act 3 can have a lot, depending on if you get what's called a Great Marsh Skip or not. What's world record? 117. So since Diablo is random maps, random, you know, item drops, all that stuff, one of the things that you run into is hard, lots of resets over and over and over again if you're looking for world records. Oh, I actually want to go check over here. I feel like we need to look over there still. I didn't explore that edge enough. Okay, it's not there. Darn. I'll just take this time to run over here and explore right there. What's the Great Marsh Skip? So the way the Great Marsh builds out, or Act 3 builds out, is it has the potential for the Great Marsh to not even be necessary. So the Great Marsh and the Flare Jungle can both come off of the Spider Forest. Sometimes you have to go through the Great Marsh to get to the Spider Forest. Other times you don't, and the Great Marsh will actually be right there, coming off of the Spider Forest, or the Flare Jungle will be right there coming off the Spider Forest itself. So you never know, and you have to kind of explore and figure it out on the way if you think that it's a Great Marsh skip or not. And it's really, really, really hard to tell the maps. The map toggle is really annoying. I know. I'm sorry. There's my staff split. It's late. I'm sorry. I missed a split. These are new splits. Like I said, I do not run. Normally my splits are just end bosses, but I figured just for comparison purposes and everything like that, it's probably better to run multi-splits. Darn. All right. Looks like we didn't find up here until fourth way. So we fourth wayed the Lost City. And this is part of the... Part of just whatever, right? Where you just have to be like, yep, Diablo 2. Sometimes you're going to find it on the first way. Other times you're going to find it on the third, fourth way. And that's what you just have to deal with. So it's a little annoying, but whatever. It is what it is. It's Diablo 2, right? Okay. So this is why I did get 7 in static. Because it gives me a better range for staticking everything. Which is super helpful. That way you don't have to stand right next to everything and just get blasted in the face, right? Give me a little range on him. Yeah, there's a splits there. Alright, so we got our exit here. Splits are... This is for speedrunning. So this is like when I get the pieces, when I do whatever. Was I complaining about the goggles? Oh yeah, for sure. Super dark. I've got them all like tinted and stuff for sun. They're like really good ski goggles. Not great for looking at screens, but whatever. It's fun. Grab that charm. It's for the hope skin cover. So in this area, I want to run left of the way I come in. So down bottom to the left there will be good. We got a boss group. So of course we will take a stop for a boss group. So I want to use static here, of course. Static does a percentage of health. Oh, grab this stuff. So of current health. So like if they are max health, static does a ton. That is not good. I'm going to die. Not fun. Snicks. I thought I had my armor on or something. I did not. Oops. That's the run. Alright. I ran out of town portals. Cool. It wasn't a great run anyways. We was a little slow anyways. Alright. That was really hard to see.